From the creepiest bat in the world to a squid that wears striped pajamas, here are 10 of the strangest and most fascinating creatures that really exist. Number 10, the hammer-headed bat. The hammer-headed bat is one of the weirdest and arguably one of the strangest looking creatures that you've most likely never even heard of. The hammer-headed bat is so bizarre that Snopes actually published an article confirming its existence because so many people thought that the pictures circulating online were all fakes. But nope, it's definitely a real bat. It looks pretty odd. It has an extremely elongated head that looks like the blunt end of a hammer and is outlandishly large. An adult hammer-headed bat ranges in body length from just under 8 inches to over 11 inches, that's almost 30 centimeters, and has a wingspan of between 27 and 38 inches, that's almost a meter across. But just what is this massive creature and why does it even exist in the first place? Well, the hammer-headed bat is what's known as a megabat, and it hails from the tropical forests of Africa, specifically Central Africa. It's one of three bat species in the area known for being a reservoir for the deadly Ebola virus. The coolest fact about the hammer-headed bat is that males have enlarged lips that let them make crazy honking sounds like a clown horn. The sound is used by males when they gather together in the hundreds to attract females. They literally fly around squawking and squawking in the hopes of finding a date. Number 9, endangered bear. What began as a viral video of what people labeled an alien creature has turned into a brave rescue story. It all started when a lethargic and hairless bear was photographed by a group of plantation workers in Borneo. As sickening as it is to say, the workers didn't know what the animal was, and so they beat it with sticks until they drove it back into the forest. But the animal was obviously sick and in need. It was a type of bear suffering from an unknown illness, and people treated it like a monster. The poor creature was eventually captured near another plantation, and according to Nixon Robi with the Sarawak Forestry Corporation, the bear is now safe and in a good place, and is also getting the help that it needs by a professional vet. The hope right now is that the bear will recover quickly so she can be placed back into the wild. It's not clear exactly what kind of bear it is, though Robi did say it was endangered. This poor creature would probably have perished if left in the hands of the evil plantation workers who beat it with sticks. Number 8, the bilby. The bilby is one of the best known marsupials in Australia. Nobody else on Earth knows what it is. Wait, do you? Probably not. This tiny marsupial looks like the Easter Bunny, but according to the World Wildlife Foundation, it is an important part of the Australian ecosystem. Bilbies are great diggers and often live inside complex burrows that can be up to 6 feet, almost 2 meters deep beneath the ground. They also live in their burrows with other animals, like reptiles, small mammals, and even birds. The burrows made by bilbies almost act as communal living spaces for many different Australian critters. Bilbies also have pouches just like kangaroos. Interestingly, the pouches face backward, unlike most other marsupials. The opening is towards the hind leg rather than towards the head. This is to prevent dirt and other materials from entering the pouch during burrowing and hunting. But here's the coolest part about the bilby. Even though it's smaller than a rabbit, it can shift thousands of pounds of soil in a single year while constructing its subterranean home. Unfortunately, the bilby is getting rarer and rarer as each year its population declines in Australia, and some are concerned that it could soon go extinct. Before Europeans settled the continent, the bilby lived on over 70% of the Australian mainland as they are highly adaptable creatures. Today, it can only be found in less than 20% of its original range. Number 7. Angora rabbit. The Angora rabbit is hands down the strangest rabbit on the planet. Many people raise these weird rabbits strictly to harvest their wool, seeing how these hippity-hoppity animals are as fluffy as it gets. The smallest of all the Angora rabbits is the English Angora, which can weigh nearly 8 pounds, around about 3.5 kilograms, and produce roughly a pound of raw fibre in a year. But then you have the biggest Angora of all, the German Angora rabbit. This thing weighs nearly 12 pounds or 5.5 kilos and is so fluffy that it can produce nearly 5 pounds or 2.5 kilos of wool in a single year. This is not the typical kind of rabbit you see hopping along the side of the road or in grassy meadows. They can get so heavy with fur that hopping is basically impossible. The weird thing about Angora rabbits is that a lot of them are the product of mixed breeding. This means they would not really survive in the wild and are as unnatural as an animal can get. For example, the giant Angora has no way to naturally shed its fur, so it needs to have its wool harvested by a human, much like a sheep. This is not something that would ever occur naturally in the wild. Angora rabbit breeders are currently in the process of officially developing new colours for acceptance at shows. What do you think of these extremely fluffy bunny rabbits? Would you ever want one? Let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to like this video and subscribe if you haven't already. Number 6. The Screaming Hairy Armadillo. The Screaming Hairy Armadillo lives up to its name. The armadillo is indeed hairy, and it does indeed scream. When threatened, the armadillo releases a loud, blood-curdling scream that can scare away even the bravest wildlife enthusiast and ward off any potential predators it deems a danger. The screaming armadillo is native to the Monte Desert in South America and has the incredible ability to eat sand. The armadillo eats shocking amounts of sand while searching for food in the harsh, dry climate it lives in. According to the Smithsonian National Zoo, this armadillo often has at least 50% of its stomach occupied by sand. It also doesn't need to drink water frequently. The screaming armadillo has such efficient kidneys that it can go very long periods without drinking, while only getting small amounts of moisture from the plants it eats. And yes, the screaming hairy armadillo does have thick armor plating over its body. The armor plates are actually overlapping scales known as scutes. The armor covers the armadillo's head all the way down to its butt. This is what you might think of as a carapace, kind of like an insect. If you're wondering just how hairy the screaming hairy armadillo is, not actually that hairy. It only has small white and brown hairs sticking out between its armor plating and all along its belly. They are solitary creatures and will spend most of their time alone in their burrows when they're not filling their bellies with food and sand. Number 5. The Raspberry Crazy Ant. The crazy ant goes by many names. The raspberry crazy ant, the hairy crazy ant, and even the tawny crazy ant. But at the end of the day, a crazy ant is a crazy ant. While you might take most everyday ants for granted, thinking they're all the same, they most certainly are not. The crazy ant is by far the craziest of all the ants. It earned its name because of the frantic and erratic way in which it moves. But what's really weird is that crazy ants are drawn to electrical equipment. There have been estimates that each year over $146 million in electric damage is caused by these crazy ants. Who knew little ants could do so much damage? But it gets even weirder. When a crazy ant is electrocuted, it releases a scent pheromone that encourages other ants in the area to find whatever killed it and take retribution. The issue is that the pheromones cause more ants to be killed by electricity, releasing more pheromones, killing more ants, attracting more ants, and eventually just spiraling out of control. When enough ants pile up, they can cause an electrical shortage. Number 4. Fried egg jellyfish. There is no other jellyfish in the ocean quite like the fried egg jellyfish. It's also sometimes known as the egg yolk jelly. This type of jellyfish has a smooth, translucent bell with a yellow glob in its center, distinctly making it look like a cracked egg floating listlessly through the water. It truly does look like a fried egg. Scientifically, it's known as Cotyledonza tuberculata. The jellyfish spend most of its time doing nothing, pulsing its yolky belly to drift perpetually through the ocean. It has a few appendages dangling from its body, allowing it to feed on things like zooplankton and smaller jellyfish. The tentacles are also very colourful, usually a deep purple. The good news is that the fried egg jellyfish is not poisonous to humans, though it could make you a bit itchy with its stingers. I definitely don't recommend trying to hold one or trying to take a bite. You can find these breakfast jellyfish commonly in the Mediterranean Sea and more sparsely throughout the rest of the world's oceans. Like a lot of other populations of jellyfish, the fried egg jellyfish's numbers ebbs and flows. So this can sometimes mean massive swarms of them during the hotter summer months, such as in July 1974, where blooms of this jelly were reportedly stretching for miles along the Israeli coast. And one last note, the fried egg jellyfish sometimes allows small animals to hitch a ride on its head. Scientists have witnessed egg yolk jellies cruising through the water with things like crabs surfing on top of their yellow bill. It's like a deep sea taxi service. Number 3. Mouse deer. A mouse deer no taller than a pencil was recently born at the Bristol Zoo in the United Kingdom. The creature is known properly as the Malayan mouse deer, and it was born as recently as the third national lockdown in the United Kingdom. This completely strange animal has long legs to support its almost disproportionate body. According to the zoo, it will only be about 3 pounds or 1.3 kilos when fully grown. In the past 10 years, this is only the second very rare mouse deer to be born at the zoo as part of the breeding program. Perhaps the most shocking thing about the mouse deer is that it's a distant relative of the ordinary deer. They can be found naturally in Southeast Asia, where they scavenge the forest floor looking for flowers and vegetables to eat. There is also the Vietnamese mouse deer, which was actually thought to be extinct for the past 30 years, until one day was caught on camera in 2019 in Vietnam. All mouse deer are tiny, adorable, and on the brink of extinction. They really are 8-inch tall or 20-centimetre deer. They'd probably make great household pets, like having a miniature house hippo. Number 2. The striped pajama squid. There is a squid living in the ocean wearing striped pajamas. The striped pajama squid is one of the only poisonous cephalopods in the entire world. It's also the only one that wears PJs. It's not as dangerous as the blue-ringed octopus or the flamboyant cuttlefish, but it does have a venomous nature. There are small glands under the squid's body that can release toxic slime to blind and poison any potential threats. Rather than injecting you with venom, the striped pajama squid squirts toxic slime into your eyes like some kind of mutant from the X-Men. But hold on to your socks. The striped pajama squid isn't a real squid. It is in fact a type of cuttlefish. It has an internal shell with 8 arms and 2 tentacles for feeding. It's also very small, living primarily in the sand and mud of shallow coastal waters through the Great Barrier Reef. They're nocturnal creatures, usually burying themselves in the sand all day long until the sun goes down and they can hunt. As for why it's wearing white and black striped pajamas, scientists believe it's to warn potential predators that it's venomous and not messing around. Number 1. Ice cream cone worm. There is no monstrosity quite like the ice cream cone worm. It's also known as a trumpet worm, and it gets its name because of the incredible cone-shaped shell that it lives inside of. And yes, at first glance, it does kind of look like an ice cream cone. The cone is made of thousands of small grains of sand, fragments of snail shells, and any other available trinket that the worm can glue together to create its armor. But here's what makes this worm the best arts and craft practitioner in all of the animal kingdom. It makes the shell itself. It has little tentacles that it uses to eat tiny critters or to help build its armor. There is a mucus undercoat on the worm that the bits of sand and shell stick to. It's a painstaking process, but one that must be done. Ice cream cone worms begin covering themselves in mucus from a very early age. Maybe because they're slightly embarrassed about having so many internal organs on display. The worm must also practice regular maintenance to keep its shell strong, thereby keeping the worm safe from predators. Thanks for watching! Which of these weird animals is your favourite? Have you heard of any of them before? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to see all the best content from the channel.